Okay, hello and welcome. And then I am planning to show you that how to use this Dremel multi-tools, this Drillbit 502, and this is really that sanding this disc, and this sandpaper is 80, and this part is suitable when I like to handle wood and then steel and any metallic things. And let's look that how I can use that when I have to sand a little bit plastic in car bumper. Okay, and here is this my tool, and this is Dremel tools, this sanding paper, what number is 502. And then I of course need this my Dremel's multi-tool, and there is this package, and here I have this my Dremel multi-tool, and let's replace, I have this Dremel 3000 multi-tool, excellent tool, and first I replace this my cutting, this drill bit, and I open that my this previous tool, and for that I have here quite much spare parts, and there is this my opening tool, it is like metallic small socket. And I press first this locking pin, and then I open in that way, in this direction, like anti-clockwise. And I rotate this bolt, and there is this my tool, now it's away. And then I open this my 508 package. Okay, and here is this my sandpaper. And then I install that in my Dremel, in this way, and then glue locking button in here, and then I only rotate that my locking bolt in here. Okay, and now sanding paper is ready, and then I have to use always protective eye mask, and hearing protection also, because this is noisy. And then let's go to look at how I start to sand my car's bumper. And then I start, there is my starting area, and next I do in here small cut that I can add in here this cutting. And there is my machine, and there is start and stop button and portable speed, and I start first in slow speed. A little bit more speed. And a little bit more speed. Okay, and now this my scratch and this cutting area, what is damaged. Now I have removed their paint, and then also I have made this area wider that I can insert next in here my padding, because this padding ends and fill on this fracture area, what is in here. And let's go to continue when I next take my padding. Okay, and now I am planning to remove these old paints and let's look what happens. There is Dremel multi-tool and opening and starting bits, and I start in low speed and I remove this old paint and more speed in here. Okay, cool. Okay, and then I need to insert in here some pre-paint, what is like a pre-for paint for this car's color, this body paint, because this is car's color paint, but before of that painting I need something base paint in here. And what I am planning to use? I am now planning to use this filler spray. Look, there is this filler spray, and that thing I am planning to add in here, and let's look at what happens when I insert that. Before of that, I need to protect this my fog light, and this is excellent tape, protective tape. Look, Scott 3M product, the best in market, what I can recommend, and I have used that product about 30 years, and this is best paint I recommend. And where I can purchase that? In US, Target, Walmart, and of course in internet, ebay.com. Now I protect that thing, and in that area I can insert this my paint, this filler paint, and let's go through this my paint. Okay, and now everything is fine for this filler spray, and there's my filler spray in here, and then I am planning to base coat that area in here. Let's look in that way, and this gives also excellent well this contact point for this my standard spray, and this filler spray also fills small holes in this my bumper. Okay, and now it looks good, and then I let this my thing to dry. And later I can, about when it has been dry, about 1 or 2 hours, I can add this my base coat. And let's continue then. Okay, and there is this my area, and here is this my fiberglass. And then I took this my plain small thing. And now I need to take this all. Sorry, I missed to take. Is fold these plastic parts away and cotton cloth. I have to take this all small things away. Good. Now it's all good. And then I can add this my fiberglass. This fiberglass is excellent because it is full of small fibers. Now my idea is to add this hole. This is my target area. Only this hole in that way, good. Good in that way, looks good. And then also here. Slow array also. Okay, excellent. That's look good. Okay, good. And then I let this thing to dry. And of course, I can take my cotton cloth and I can take this all extra things in here away, because otherwise I have to sandpaper these extra things away. Now it is easier to take, because this is like, it is not yet hard, because it became really hard. Then I can, if we have protective glove, we can use, but do not ever touch that in your hand, because this is really harmful. Okay, now I let this thing to dry. It needs to dry something like 1 hour. And then I can use my sandpaper. Okay, and soon we continue with sandpaper.